I want to start this particular session with a slightly different approach, where I want to begin with some kind of interaction. I want to understand from you, what is DevOps? Very generic question. What do you think is DevOps? I'm talking in general, DevOps. Don't Google. Whatever is there on top of your head, maybe you can just contribute with that content. You don't have to Google. You can just speak. What do you think is DevOps? Yeah, go ahead.
Good morning, sir. This is Vishnu here. Nice to meet you, sir. So from my point of view, DevOps is an automation process to automate whatever we are doing in the organization manual process to become an deployment process or a testing process. Whatever things it's in manual, we are trying to do it in the automation process.
Perfect. So, so basically it's all about automation.
Yes, correct. Yes,
more
exactly. Just to
oh, one is enough.
Manual interaction.
Let's others.
Yeah, sure, sure.
Srinivas, go ahead.
Yeah, it's nothing but development plus operations is DevOps.
Development plus operation.
Operations.
Very good.
Yeah.
Want to elaborate something more?
It fulfills the gap between development and operation, we can say.
Reduces or removes the gap. Reduces or removes the gap between dev and ops. Okay. More? Yeah, Stephen.
It communicates with both development team and operations team and maintain the code and everything in everything which needs for an application.
So we can call it as manage project assets.
Yeah.
Right? That's what we can say. It can help us to manage the assets of the project. Stefan.
Yeah, I just got in the meeting, but I guess the question was what is DevOps, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, from my understanding, I think DevOps is it's all what the other classmates said, but it's also the ability to put in place like a process of CI and the CD pipeline for the.
So it's about creating a CI and CD pipeline.
Yeah, integration of codes and deployment of artifacts in the process.
Deployment of artifacts, CI, CD pipeline, okay.
We can easily shift our application from test to production or UAT to production. Life cycle is less.
Reduce the timeline for commit to production.
Yeah, and
from
any
the
other
time
changes.
We commit the code to the time we produce the publish the code to production to publish
yes.
to production. We want to reduce that time. Very good. Very, very, very good.
Yep.
Reduce the time required for publishing from commit to perfect. Absolutely perfect. More. See, so many inputs. So nice. More. Okay. I'll change the question a bit. I'm not giving my answer, right? I'm just taking everybody's inputs. Why DevOps? One, I can definitely move this here. So if I say why, DevOps, I can move. It reduces the time required from commit to publish of application to production.
Saving time and resources.
It saves time and resources. Fantastic.
Minimize manual intervention in process.
Very good. Minimize manual.
Also reduce friction between development and
reduce the friction, minimize manual intervention. Friction is reduced.
Easier project management effort.
Sorry?
Increase project manager's effort in coordination between reduce, the developer and ops.
Reduce PM efforts, okay.
Collaborative work between the team members.
It helps us to collaborate. No doubt about it, yes.
For Kennedy-based deployment.
Different deployment patterns, multiple deployment patterns, or I would say smooth deployment of
the client
application with minimal impact to the consumers, correct? Impact to users, okay.
Deliver the quality of
quality
product to the client.
Ensure quality of work, quality of tasks. Very good. More.
Maintenance of existing application or deployment.
Maintenance of application or deployment. Uh-huh. DevOps maintenance, okay. And the list can go on actually. It's never ending. So these are all your inputs basically, right? I mean, and right now it makes no sense for today's date to have a project without DevOps. If you don't have project, it's okay. But having a project and we don't have DevOps, we are wasting lot of energy, lot of time, lot of things we might redo again and again. We get reusability. We get speed, agility. We get record of everything which we do. We get advantage of rolling back quite easily if something goes wrong. I mean, I'm just trying to identify from top of my head certain things which probably are not there in the list. I can not only go forward, I can go back if needed quite easily. I can audit everything which is done in the SDLC, software development lifecycle. I can attach responsibility to individuals to perform their jobs without exception, with the way of sending notification to them and recording the notification. So, yes, the whole thing is about automation. We are trying to eliminate human dependency in all the places possible and bring a system in place. The Ambanis don't have to go and sit in each and every store, right, to sell. Why? Because they have brought a system in place. Because they have everything process driven. If this is the situation, this is what is supposed to be done. Everything is drafted well in advance. It's completely process driven. It's not human driven. Because the uncle has come to the shop and he helped me in my childhood days for something, I have to give him special 20% discount. This kind of things won't happen in a store which is process or system driven. Even if that has to be given, that should be already accommodated well in advance in the system. Human intelligence and emotions don't mix. It's only the intelligence which takes the decision, not the emotions. That's what is all automation about. an intelligent decision, not an emotional because emotional decisions are going to change from time to time. Based on what is the mind frame, things would change. But if intelligent decision is taken, that would remain fixed. So we want to bring intelligent decision in a project development life cycle, SDLC. Whether it is prepare phase, whether it is design phase, whether it is build or deploy. Four phases, right? Four stages of SDLC. Prepare, design, build, and deploy. What most of us do is we use DevOps during build, we use DevOps during deploy, but we don't think about using DevOps in prepare and design phase also. But DevOps participates right from the time something has become an idea. Right from the time it was an idea to the time that idea has reached the customer. DevOps is a complete cycle. So it's all about not only excellence in development, design, build, deploy. DevOps is also about excellence in post-deployment. We can call it as operate. So based on when the application is being operated, there would be feedback, and the feedback would again go into the system, and again we'll start doing all these things, again improve, and it's a circle. This is one part, this is the other part. We generally call this as engineering excellence, and the later part we call it as operational excellence. Engineering excellence will lead to operational excellence. Operational excellence will again give feedback for improving your engineering excellence.